Alright, so this is a video of setting up the snake cage for two. It's a 40-gallon breeder tank made by Zilla, I believe it is. So it's a sliding door. You can see the screen right here. And so you just slide it on right here. Very safe. Few things. I got it for free. And they actually... This is all cracked up. That's why it's all sealed up. So what I did was take really thin plexiglass, or not plexiglass, acrylic glass, and I siliconed it shut to one side, and on the other side I did the same thing. So I did that, heavily siliconed it, siliconed all the cracks right here. That actually is glass missing right there. So right now it's pretty safe for them not to get out. And it's not waterproof, go figure. Thanks to the cracks, but Zilla is generally not made for this, for water stuff. The sliding doors aren't. Some people think they are, but they're not. It even says on the sticker. And if you don't see that sticker, then somebody's peeled it off. So, like I said, it's previously owned, so I got this for free. So all I'm doing right now, start off, is chucking coca fiber that I broke up with a coca fiber brick. And all I did was take hot water. It says 4 quarts for per brick. I used 2 to 3 quarts of hot water, so it wasn't as wet, and it stayed pretty dry. It's like right now the dryness is like taking taking it out of a bag of dirt. Right now that's just how wet it is. It's not really wet at all, but the moisture isn't, so it's pretty good. Just blabbling on. So right now I'm putting the coca fiber in, like I said, and I will then be putting in hideouts. The reason I have 2 snakes and one in a 40-gallon, you really shouldn't. But these two girls are actually the one adult, which is my oketee. I showed you guys. She is only 3-4 feet, or 3 feet, I should say, 3 feet. And she's not going to get any bigger because she's 4 years old. They continually grow, but she won't get much bigger now that she has reached her age of maturity. Spread out, coca fiber. I try to keep a thin layer on. I don't like using much of this stuff. Just enough for them to hide in if they want, put some stuff on, look good. Even it out, leveled out, look nice. Coca fiber is used a lot. People use aspen. I don't like aspen personally. It's too dusty for me. This stuff isn't dusty at all. So that's something nice about it. So I got the layer down. So right now I will be taking things, just a bunch of different objects, sticking them in random places. Snakes are in this cage right now. And I will be taking the stuff out and sticking them in there. So this is a 30-gallon tank. And there's one. So this is a very... This is a 12 by 18 background that I purchased a long time ago. I got it from a friend or something. But it works. And it looks nice. And they like hiding behind it, as you can see. This is my snow corn, or my mom's snow corn, I should say, not mine. And she is pink with white and some yellow abbreviated around her white, if you can see that yellow in there. And she's still a baby. She's almost a year. We got her in September at the Mid-Atlantic Reptile Show in Maryland. And she has been growing since. So she's a foot and a half, I say foot, almost 2 feet. I'll leave it at that. Not 2 feet exact, but almost 2 feet. She's actually getting down a large, a regular sized mouse, large hopper, which is good because that means good for me and good for her, just because the mouse lasts longer. People say you could feed them twice a week when they're younger. I did that for her for a time, and the other oketee for a time, and it helped the oketee get a little bigger. and it was nice, but I said, you know, let's just bump it up higher and bump the mouse size higher and, you know, let them do their thing. And that's what I did. And now they are on one mouse a week. And there's nothing wrong with that. So, you know, they're doing good with that. So I'm just putting things in here randomly. Really, I love decorating cages. I have an issue with this. Just doing terrariums in general, I like to do. So I just stick things in there, and after a while it looks good. So here's the oketee. Very small. I mean, you know, this isn't a very big cage. Hide out. Come on, baby, get out. She is very stubborn. She actually rescued / was given to by a friend. And the reason I say rescue is because they weren't taking very good care of it. They were staying with one size mouse their entire life. And that was actually a Pinky. And they recently just bumped it up to a Fuzzy when we first got her. And I actually immediately bumped her up to a Hopper. And she's fattened up. Now she's eating regular size mice. But she's still around 3 feet, like I said. She's very pretty, though. She has her personality. She's very, nosy. Very nosy snake. But she does not like being touched because she was, she escaped, and she was a wild snake for a time. So that's just, a no-no. Her neighbors found her outside 3 months later, and they caught it and gave it back to my friends. And they were like, okay, it's time. Nobody cares about it, so let's just give it to the people that have all the animals. And we took her in and put her with the other one. And they've been doing great ever since. They're, you know, people say putting snakes together isn't a very good idea. But, you know, I disagree. They like to have a friend in there. Same sex. I would suggest doing females if you plan on doing that, not two males. Two males during mating season, they will get very territorial, very aggressive. Females, they could care less. And of course, you don't want to put a male and female unless you're breeding. So, this is their tank that I did in like, what, 8 minutes? And you know, for 8 minutes, the supplies I had, it looks very good. So they hide out behind the background, just like I showed in my other snake, Susie. Her tank, she has that background too. They like that. This is cork bark. This is cork bark. And actually, this is cork bark, but it's made for a background, so it's a little bit different material, but it's the same stuff. And this cork bark is made into a tree branch. It's very expensive. I think this was $15, $20. And it's very small. This stuff you could buy probably for $5, $10 at a reptile show. And that's pretty much where you can only get them besides buying them online. Reptile shows are nice. You got the breeders there. You just gotta know who to go to and trust. So if you find a store at a reptile show that sells supplies, ask the people that work there because they probably will know the most, the best people to go to for animals like that. Because they obviously have their own reptiles and they know who to go to. So, like I said, this is their tank. 40-gallon breeder. Took 8 minutes to finish. Looks very good. And I will keep you posted.